So literally everything just kind of got stripped away, including my taste buds.
When Achatz first went into treatment, he didn't believe he was going to lose his taste. There were some days we were tasting stuff out, and all of a sudden he'd say, "This is no salt. This needs way more salt." We'd all kind of look at him and be like, "This has enough salt, doesn't it?" And be like, "Yes, chef."
I realized that I couldn't taste. All the charting and the scans were showing tumor size reduction, but the doctors couldn't tell me with any certainty that I would ever be able to taste again. How can you be a chef? How can you cook and not be able to taste?
He was lost. The one thing that he did, he couldn't do. That was it. That was his entire life there.
Everybody was fearful that the restaurant would get really slow. I felt like I had to prove that I was still in the game. I feel like the determination kicked in. We need to keep showing people that we're still innovating.
He would sketch a dish on paper and take a photo of it and send it to us. It would be like, burnt bread puree. Make sure it's burnt. Season it with this acid, but not too acidic. And we'd go back and forth on a scale of like, if a pickle's a 5 and bread's a 1, how acidic do you want it? And that I found was really the best way to understand what things should taste like.
There was a light bulb that went off and said, for the first time ever, I think I can be a chef without being able to taste. Because it's up here. It's not here.
This is going to kind of sound weird, but I honestly think him being sick taught him how to be a chef. Before, it was always he had to do it, and he would plate the dish for the first week or 2 weeks before anyone was allowed to plate it. Now, he's creating food without ever touching it.
I realized that to make a world-class restaurant, you can't do it yourself. You have to take the voice of all these people. So I said, we need to engender this. We shouldn't box it in. We should